हाय हेलो ऑल माय डियर्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? हैव यू टेकन योर ब्रेकफास्ट? व्हाट डिड यू ईट इन द ब्रेकफास्ट? इडली, डोसा, पूरी, चपाती, उपमा. यूजुअली वी ईट मेनी मोर फूड आइटम्स इन द ब्रेकफास्ट. हु प्रिपेयर फूड मा? हु प्रिपेयर फूड फॉर यू? योर मदर, समटाइम्स योर फादर, समटाइम्स योर ग्रैंड मदर. यूजुअली योर मदर ओनली प्रिपेयर्स फूड फॉर यू. ओके, डू यू नो वेर डू वी गेट ऑल दीज फूड आइटम्स? ओके, एंड विच टाइप ऑफ फूड डू ईट अम्मा? वी ईट एवरी डे डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ फूड. डू यू नो वेर डू वी गेट ऑल दीज? हैव यू प्रिपेयर राइस? हैव यू प्रिपेयर ब्रिंजॉल टोमेटो एंड नट्स एंड पल्सेस? हैव यू प्रिपेयर मैंगो? इज इट पॉसिबल टू प्रिपेयर मैंगो एंड टोमेटो एंड ब्रिंजॉल एंड लेडीज फिंगर एंड फूड ग्रेन्स नट्स एंड पल्सेस? नो, नॉट एट ऑल. यस, हु गिव अस ऑल दीज? Who give us all these plants only? What about the plants? Are they need food like you? They don't depend on us. They only prepare the food. So plants prepare food themselves. Okay, they do not depend on others. Okay, we only depend on animals. Only depend on plants for our food. So who prepares the food for us? Plants only. Who produce food for us? Green plants only produce food for us. Okay, we do not make all these, amma. We get most of the food items from the green plants only. Okay, na? So they don't depend on us. How did they prepare food? Today's topic is that is only how the green plants prepare the food. That is the topic today. So lesson number 2, food factory. What is the name of lesson number 2? Food factory. What is the food factory of the plant? Your mother prepare food in the kitchen only. So like that, which part of the plant prepare food? Leaf only. Okay, that's why leaf is called food factory of the plant and also called kitchen of the plant. Okay, so leaf is called food factory of the plant and also kitchen of the plant. Now we will discuss about the structure of a green leaf. So without plants there would be no life on the earth. Plants are very important for us. All the living things depend on plants for our survival. Without green plant there would be no life on the earth. Okay, we get majority of food, we get oxygen also from the green plants only. Is it clear? Now we will discuss about the structure of a leaf, how many parts it has. Okay, let me explain. Okay, see here, this flat. Okay, green portion of the leaf is called leaf blade or leaf lamina. Okay, so what is the green part of the leaf? What is the flat part of the leaf? This flat and green part of the leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. Okay, lamina. Lamina only absorb the more sunlight for making food. What is this, ma? See here, see this leaf. This green color, flat and broad portion of the leaf is called leaf blade. Okay, leaf blade is also called lamina. Okay, now observe carefully. Okay, all leaves are attached to the stem with a stalk. All leaves are attached to the stem. See here, all leaves are attached to the stem with a stalk. Okay, that stalk is called petiole. Already have to learn in last year. Okay, this stalk is called petiole. This stalk gives support to the leaf. Now we will discuss about the parts of a leaf. So all leaves are attached to the stem with a stalk. That stalk is also called petiole. Stalk gives support to the leaf. Okay, and see what is the name of this portion, amma? This flat green and broad part of a leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. What is the use of leaf blade? They only absorb more sunlight from the sun. Leaf lamina or leaf blade. The entire part of the leaf is called lamina or leaf blade. So the flat part of the leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. What is the use of lamina? They absorb more sunlight for making food. Okay, now come on, see here. Turn the leaf, ma. In the middle of the leaf, one thick line is present. That is called midrib. Okay, that is called midrib. See this leaf, ma. Take leaf. This is the take leaf. In the center of the leaf, one thick line is present. That is called midrib. This is called midrib. See here, this thick line of in the center of the leaf, one thick line is present. That is called midrib. Okay, see this side of the leaf. Thick line is there in the middle of the leaf. From the thick line, there are small lines arise from the midrib. These are called side veins. Is it clear? See this leaf in the center of the leaf. See here, green color. Okay, this portion of the leaf is called midrib. In the center of the leaf, one thick line is present. That is called midrib. From the midrib, small lines arise from the midrib. No, children, those are called side veins. These are all the side veins. Okay, is it clear? This is the leaf stalk. In the center of the leaf is called midrib or main vein. Okay, these small lines are called side veins. What is the use of these veins, ma? Veins give support to the leaf and also carry water and food material. Okay, now see here, this is also vein, no, children. Veins give support to the leaf and also carry the water from the stem to leaf. Okay, and also food is prepared in the leaves, no? So veins carry the food from the leaf to different parts of the plant and also carry the water from the stem to the leaf. So what is the main function of the veins, ma? Veins give support to the leaf and also carry water and food from leaves to other parts of the plant. Now, what are the parts of the leaf, ma? Leaf stalk. Center of the leaf is a midrib. These small lines are called side vein. This flat portion of the leaf is called leaf blade. Okay, na? Leaf blade or lamina. What is the use of lamina? Absorb the more sunlight for making food. Why are the leaves green in color? Is it a green or brown? It is a green. Why are the leaves green in color? They contain one green pigment that is called chlorophyll. Why are the leaves green in color? They contain a green pigment that is called chlorophyll. Chlorophyll gives green color to the leaf. Chloro means green. Chloro means green. Phyll means leaf. Green leaf. Okay. So, green pigment present in the leaves that gives green color to the leaf. That pigment is called chlorophyll. Is it clear, ma? Okay. Chlorophyll has the power to absorb the sunlight. Okay. Chlorophyll has the power to absorb the more sunlight from the sun for making food. Is it clear? So most of the plants have green color leaves because they contain a green pigment that is called chlorophyll. Okay, now this is the structure of a leaf. Underside of the leaf, number of tiny pores are present, children. Those are called stomata. We breathe through the nose, no, children. What is the nose of a plant? Are plants to breathe like you? Yes, plants also breathe like you. We breathe through the nose. How do plants breathe? Plants to breathe through stomata. Where are the stomatas are present? Underside of the leaf. Number of tiny pores are present, but we cannot see with our naked eye. Okay, we can see only with the help of microscope. Why? Because they are very tiny openings, tiny structures. Most of the green plants, tiny pores are present underside of the leaf only. Some water plants, tomatoes are present upper surface of the leaf. Is it clear, amma? So how do plants breathe? Plants breathe through stomata. What is the nose of a plant? Stomata. Okay, na? So where are the stomatas are present? Underside of the leaf. Okay, many more stomatas are present. I will show to you. These are all the bean shaped
bean shaped structures. Okay, na. So if you turn the leaf, yes, if you turn the leaf under the microscope, you can see many minute openings surrounded by a bean shaped cells. These are called stomata. Is it clear? So plants to breathe through stomata only. So listen. What is meant by photosynthesis? Already you know that green plants prepare their own food. What are the ingredients they need for preparing biryani? We need rice, water and spices and chilli, tomato, carrot. We have to add some ingredients for making biryani. Is it clear? So how do plants make food? What are the ingredients they need? Let us discuss about these. So all green plants prepare their food with the help of sunlight, water. Okay, let us discuss about these. See here, this is a guava plant, ma. Fruits also there. We eat the guava fruits, no children. So how the plants prepare the food? What is that process? Okay, let us discuss. So actually roots grow under the ground, no children. Roots absorb water from the soil. Already water contains minerals, salts, nutrients. Okay, na? So roots absorb all these nutrients, water from the soil and send to the stem. Stem also gives water and minerals and nutrients to the branches, to leaves. Okay, so see here, how the green plants make their own food, what we call that process, let us discuss some. So all green plants prepare the food with the help of sunlight. Sunlight is very essential for the green plants. Without sunlight, plants cannot make their own food. So sunlight is very important. Already water is present in the soil. Okay, now during the rainy season, rainwater reaches the ground. So which part of the plant grows in the ground? Roots only. So roots absorb water from the soil and send to remaining parts of the plant. So already leaves contain chlorophyll, no children. So water from the soil, okay na, sunlight from the sun. Already air contains the gases. Air is a mixture of gases. Plants need carbon dioxide gas for making food. So what are the ingredients necessary for making food, ma? All green plants use water from the soil. Already leaves contain chlorophyll. Okay, they take carbon dioxide from the air only, from the atmosphere only. Sun also produce sunlight. All these requirements present in the environment only. They don't depend on others. Okay, surrounds the plants, all these requirements present in the present around us, present around the plants. Yes, so plants use all these things for making food. That process is called photosynthesis. Is it clear? So what is called photosynthesis? Photo means light. Photo means light. Synthesis means putting together. Okay, photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means what? Photo means light. Synthesis means putting together. Putting together with the help of light, all green plants make their own food. That process is called photosynthesis. I come again. What is called photosynthesis? All green plants make their own food. So the process by which green plants make their own food, with the help of water and carbon dioxide and sunlight. Okay, with the help of chlorophyll also. Chlorophyll is also absorb the sunlight, no children. Chlorophyll has power to absorb the sunlight. So they make their own food. So green plants make their own food with the help of water, okay na, and carbon dioxide and sunlight. Okay, they make their own food. That process is called photosynthesis. Is it clear, amma? What is called photosynthesis? What is called photosynthesis, amma? Photosynthesis is derived from the two Greek words, amma, photo and synthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means putting together. So putting together with the light only, they make their own food. So the process in which green plants make their own food with the help of chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, air and water and sunlight is called photosynthesis. Is it clear? Is it clear? Photosynthesis means all green plants make their own food. That process is called photosynthesis. So during the process of photosynthesis, they release oxygen. They release oxygen, which is very very essential for all living organisms. Okay na, during the process of photosynthesis, plants release byproduct, that is oxygen. That is oxygen. That prepared food is called sugar or glucose. Plants prepared food, that prepared food is called sugar. These are all the byproducts of photosynthesis. What are the byproducts of photosynthesis? Oxygen and sugar. Sugar is nothing but glucose. Is it clear, Amma? The process in which green plants make their own food with the help of chlorophyll and carbon dioxide, okay, and sunlight and water is called photosynthesis. During the process of photosynthesis, they release oxygen and sugar. Those are all the byproducts of photosynthesis. Is it clear, Nana? Okay, let us revise. Ma, what is the structure of a leaf? What is the name of the lesson? Food factory. What is the food factory of the plant? Green leaf only. What is the kitchen of the plant? Green leaf only. Now we will discuss about the structure of a leaf. No, children, leaf is attached to the stem with a stalk. Stalk gives support to the leaf only. If you observe the leaf carefully, the flat part of the leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. What is the use of lamina? They absorb more sunlight for making food. In the center of the leaf, one thick line is present. No, children, what is that? That is called midrib. That is called midrib or main vein. Okay, from the midrib, see here, lines, smaller lines are present. No, children, what we call them? Side veins. Okay, na? In the center of the leaf, midrib or main vein, side lines are called side veins. What are the uses of veins? They give support to the leaf. At the same time, they carry water from the stem to leaf, food from the leaf to other parts of the plant. Is it clear? These are all the parts of a leaf. Stalk, main vein, okay, main vein or midrib, okay, side veins, and this flat portion, green flattened portion, is called leaf blade or lamina. Is it clear? Full, this is green flat portion of the leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. Center of the leaf, thick line, that is called midrib. From the midrib, smaller lines arise from the midrib. Those are called side veins. This is called stalk. Is it clear? These are all the main parts of the leaf. Okay, and what is meant by photosynthesis? All green plants use water from the soil. Okay, and the sun produce sunlight. Okay, already leaves contain chlorophyll. Okay, air is a mixture of gases, no, carbon dioxide they need for making food. Carbon dioxide also mixture, okay, carbon dioxide is also present in the air. So all green plants use water from the soil, okay, sunlight from the sun, carbon dioxide from the air, okay, and with the help of chlorophyll, they make their own food. That process is called photosynthesis. During the process of photosynthesis, they release oxygen, okay, na, and sugar, that is glucose. Those are all the byproducts of photosynthesis. By means two. What are the two products they release during the process of photosynthesis? Oxygen, which is very essential for us. For breathing only. Without oxygen, we cannot live. Life is not possible for living. So all animals and human beings also may die without oxygen. So who release oxygen? Green plants only release oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. And also they release prepared food, that is called sugar, is nothing but glucose. Is it clear, children? Tomorrow we will discuss about some more other uses of plants. Okay, today you have to read the textbook. Okay, you have to read the textbook. Bye, take care, see you later.